another very useful, I find it one of the most useful tags. So what URL helps me is that in my Django views, the user's app will have this client view, okay? And this will route to some slash user slash clients. So I could hard code my AHREF to that user slash clients, but throughout the development lifecycle of my app, that URL may change, right? And where is that map? In urls.py. So that urls.py should be one point stop for getting your entire URL structure. It should not be that if you say 1 month later, I decide to change my URL to something user slash clients or my clients or something like that. Then I have to go through my entire web stack and all my templates, I have to change slash user slash clients to slash user slash my clients. This should not happen. So one point stop is in urls.py you change that URL and you use the URL template tag to link it. Right? So when I use so I could have used AHREF URL clients, but I might want to use this later as well. So what I do is my client ID here is the parameter taken by URL. So it will be slash user slash clients slash one or something like that. Client ID will be passed by the context. And then I can also use this as keyword to get a variable. And I can use this variable multiple number of times. Right? See how it helps. So what I could have done is slash user slash clients, but then I would have to change it everywhere I use this URL structure. Instead, I'll use the URL keyword, and this is how I generate my URLs. This is a very clean way to do URLs in Django. This wasn't there before, but it's quite helpful. Sorry. Okay. So with just one look at it makes sense. So what I'm doing is I'm initializing some variables with some values, and throughout the with and with block tag, in anywhere in between, I could use these variables to however I like. So this is how you define variables inside a Django template. So there are a lot more tags. I'll show you. You can probably get into the Django documentation. This is like a huge list of tags. I just covered the few interesting ones. So we'll move to filter. So what filters does is you have a variable and then you pipe it to a filter. Okay. So these are string filters. So I have defined value to something, and then you could. These are really helpful. You can change it to lowercase, uppercase, title case. You can get the length. You can cut it. So how it takes parameters is after the pipe and the filter name, then you put a colon and then you pass the arguments. So my argument here is a blank space bar, right? A space. So what it does is it removes space from the entire sentence. There is another one called main list, which makes it into a list. So these are really helpful if you are doing stuff. Text filters. What line breaks does is very interesting. So you have a paragraph which has slash n as line breaks and slash n and another slash a blank line as a paragraph break. So that's a text, okay? And when you just print it, you have to put it inside a p tag so that it maintains that structure. Otherwise, it doesn't. So if you pass it through a line breaks filter, what it does is it takes in all the slash n's and puts a br slash. So it makes a line break. And all the paragraphs, it changes to p slash p. So it adds those tags. So it's very helpful when you are rendering paragraphs and text into the browser without using the p tags. Right? What line number does is just adds a line number into your entire paragraph. Slugify is very helpful. So what it does is, if you have something like so you have seen log names which is like log.com slash y So what I did today as a sentence would be the name of your blog, but then it slugifies it into a URL structure, which can be taken as a parameter and broken down, and you can fetch data from your database. So this is what slugify does. Okay. Truncate characters is I think you know, because it takes 15 as a value. So at 15 it cuts it off and puts a dot dot at the ellipsis. Truncate words does the same thing but with words. And word wrap will wrap your entire text into the number of characters you provide. Okay. Yeah.
Do we have pages?
I'm sure we have. No, he's asking about replace, a string replace. I'm sure we have, I can't remember the tag right now. I'll probably look into it. Yeah. No, there are split with words, but I think they split filter as well. The reason why Django templates is so difficult to, all these things are missing, is all this logic ideally should be taken care of by the application, not inside the template. And if you want to split things, if you want to replace stuff, do it in your inside your controllers, not inside the template. Template should be really, really dumb. It should just have data and it should render. The maximum it should do is some if-else and some looping through it. Right?
Sometimes
you may need, and for that we have custom, we can write custom tags and filters. I'll get into that at the end of my slides. I have. Okay, so moving forward, this is a really helpful tag if you are working with HTML data. So remove tags, pspan, and then it takes some parameters. And so what it will do is, if your entire text has p tags and span tags and div tags, it will just remove it. You can add whatever tags you want. Strip tags will remove one tag. Okay. Escape will escape your less than with a percentile LG and percentile GT and the ampersands and everything. So that is, and escape.js will escape it for JavaScript. Similarly, array filters is very, you just read it and set the side value first, last, then there is join, and there is length, and there are more. Slice is how Python slice works. So this is the argument which you pass when you slice it, when you do an array. So when you do something like this, so you have. So this is how you split array, right? So the same parameter you need to pass into as a string to slice, and then it'll slice it for you. So 1, 4, 4, 2, 3. So you just, it's similar to Python. Just that this is how you pass it. Okay, date and time. Django provides this nice tag called now, which is the date time dot now. Okay, and then you can pass it to a filter called date and provide this the same string you provide to the str, and it'll format the time for you. This is very helpful for formatting times. And then there's another filter called time since and time until, which will make you date like 10 days ago or 15 minutes ago. This is a very weird tag, okay. So, Rails has this thing called, when you do a pluralize of Rails on a Rails string, it by itself figures out whether it needs an ES or it needs to remove a Y and put a ES in there, and does it for you. Here what you have to do is, so I have a message count, okay, and I have to show you have, so 10 messages, and if it is 1, then it is 10, 1 message, or 0 message, right? So I pass it message count, and I pass it pluralize. What it does is, if message count is more than 1, it returns S, otherwise it returns nothing. So you have 1 message, or you have 10 messages. Make sense? Similarly, when we have a noun, the plural of which is a ES, so I pass this pass this argument called ES, and this is what gets returned or rendered when the value of followers count is more than 1. Similarly, in Cherry, it could be either Y or it could be IGS. So I write CHERR and I put it pass in this. So if it is 1, it's Cherry, otherwise it's Cherry. There are I'll just cover a few, some interesting tags. So, you'll have tables, okay? And sometimes the value of a attribute might be none or false. So if you just output that, it'll actually, in Django, it will print none. I don't want that. So if my value is none, I want output of a dash, that's all. So value, I pipe it to default is none, and I pass this optional argument for dash. So whenever my value is none, I get dash. Similarly, default is for false values. Dict sort is quite helpful. I don't know why it is given there, but it's helpful. Say if you have a list of dictionaries, and that dictionary has a key called name, and if you want to sort by the value of name, this is how you do a dictionary. This is a very interesting one called phone to numeric. So if you have a phone number like 1 and 0 you collect, it gets rendered as. So you know how this works, right? If you open your phone and if you type the letters as it is there, this is the number which gets there. It gets there. Unordered list is, if my value is a list, so it will be a list inside a list inside a list, it will get rendered as a LIN UL, so it will be rendered something like a list, and then second level of list and third level of list. So Django contrims has this optional package called Humanize. What it does is, if you load Humanize, well, you'll get few more filters. App number, what it does is, if you have one, if you have a figure one, it converts to ON. Works for everything from 1 to 9. You know how it's used. Int comma puts a comma into integers. Int word makes your integers into words. So if you pass a date, natural day will change your date to something like 10 days ago. Natural time will change it to few minutes ago, like things you see on Facebook. Ordinal will take 1 and make 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 21st, 23rd. Static pricing is really useful if you have an app, and if you are using local static files and data, you want to deploy it, and if you want to put your static files into an AWS or someplace. Right. So your settings will take care of where the media comes from, and if you use this static stack, this will take care of the entire abstracting of where the static files come from. You don't have to really link it to it. So this was the all this time we were covering tags and filters provided by Django itself. We can of course write our own custom tags. This is how we do it. So inside your app, just make a new directory called template tags. Make an init.py and I'll call the apps a file app extras. And just I have to load app extras inside my template. So whatever tags and filters are defined inside this will get loaded into the template. And then we can use that. How do we write template tags? So this is the same implementation of the lower which we are using, the slab, the value pipe lower. So it takes in from Django input template and into this. And then it takes in two decorators. Decorator takes optional parameter called name. So if this was not passed, the tag will be called mylower. But because I have passed a name, this is how the tag will be known inside the entire template. And just because it's a string filter, I pass another decorator called string filter, which makes sure that it only takes in string values. Okay. This is how we write a custom tag. Similarly, custom filters, the same way, it takes in arguments and it returns stuff. So, my custom filter will be name default, and this will be the argument which it expects, and and this is the first, of course, this is the one of the first arguments, and this is the second argument. And then you do whatever you want to do with this and then you render it. So this is what the custom filter is. If there is a filter already defined, you can override it. You cannot change. Yeah, of course you can change it, because I'll just show you an example. So, this one. So safe is a filter I forgot to talk about. So what safe does is, if you have, by default, whatever values you pass inside this lock tags gets escaped, because it could be dirty values, it could have HTML in it and it could break stuff. So when you write safe, you tell Django template explicitly that this is safe to render as is. Okay. So safe is one of the filters. So I pipe it to remove tags and then I pipe it to save. Otherwise, when you remove tags, the other tags will not be visible. So this is how piping works. That's how chaining works. So I think that's the end. There are a few useful links. You can just go to docs.django.org and click on templates, and it has a good documentation. Django has really good documentation. So any questions? Yeah.
When I was exploring that way, I came across SSI.
SSI,